Hi, my name is Paul. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. Today, let's take a look at the supply curve and some factors that influence it. In normal circumstances, the supply curve is upward sloping, which means that as prices rise, so does quantity, as firms are incentivized to produce more with higher prices in order to maximize total revenue. Firms also have to consider production costs when making a good. Recall that when firms begin production, the average total cost might be higher than the marginal cost because of high fixed income costs that get spread over a limited amount of quantity. However, as fixed costs get spread over each additional unit, the marginal cost might be higher than the average total cost over time. And that's seen on the graph as point A moves to point B. For some firms, producing more may lead the marginal cost to be increasing with each unit produced. In that case, the average total cost curve faced by a producer can move from point B to point C. In the real world, that can take the form of more factories being produced or more money spent in storing inventories. In the long run, firms may optimize their production strategies, and their long-run marginal costs can look steady over time. Some firms, especially firms in imperfect market structures, have optimized their production strategies to take advantage of economies of scale. Economies of scale is the idea where each additional unit costs less to make than the unit before. Graphically, we can see that with a downward sloping average total cost curve, which means as the unit produced increases, the average total cost decreases. An example of economies of scale can be seen in the agricultural industry. As farmers buy more productive farming equipment, the cost of producing one additional unit of food declines, which can lower costs for consumers as well. Diseconomies of scale are the opposite. As the quantity produced increases, so does the average total costs. Diseconomies of scale puts firms in a difficult situation because that means that the prices that they have to pass on to consumers have to increase faster than the price of the production of a particular good, or else the firm will exit over a long period of time. A real-life example of diseconomies of scale can be seen in the cryptocurrency space, where for some cryptocurrencies, it takes more and more computing power to make an additional coin than it does for the prior coins being produced. Sometimes the supply curve can have a parallel shift. As you can see, as the supply curve moves to the right and quantity Q moves from Q to Q prime, which means more quantity is being produced. Several factors can influence the supply curve. At the most basic level, the parallel shift in supply curve usually represents a fundamental change in production. Conversely, the supply curve can also shift to the left, which means that production is costlier if they're moved in the other direction. The supply curve may have a parallel shift due to advancements in technology, changes in input in raw materials or input costs, or tax and regulatory changes that incentivize or disincentivize means of production for a particular good. When input costs decrease, consumers can also benefit from more quantity supplied or a lower observed price at a fixed quantity. So that's how economies of scale and diseconomies of scale can affect firm strategy when it comes to production. Please visit us at Chegg to view additional topic videos, walk through example problems, or even meet some of our subject matter experts. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you at Chegg.